Welcome to Hip Hop Walkthroughs. In this episode, I'll be demonstrating how I remade the instrumental to Blurred Lines by Robin Thicke, featuring Pharrell and T.I. Not only did I remake this instrumental, I created my own blend that I called the Sureshot Edit. The instrumental for Blurred Lines is influenced by Marvin Gaye's 1977 hit, Got to Give It Up. It's no surprise because Pharrell, who produced the record, has created many songs that were inspired by classic artists. Also, Robin Thicke is an artist who has cited Marvin as an inspiration. I figured I'd take pieces from both of these records and blend them together to create my own version. First, let's take a look into the Reason session where I started. For the drums, I chose samples that were sonically similar to the original. Pharrell used drum samples to create a groove similar to the Marvin Gaye record. The kick drum is playing a 4-on-the-floor pattern. Here's the snare pattern with a clap on the 4th bar. I have 2 hi-hats at different velocities playing 8th notes. And there's also an open hi-hat that hits with the snare drum. One thing Pharrell does really well is use percussive elements. In the original, he uses a cowbell to play a really cool rhythm. Here's the first pattern. And the second pattern. And here's the entire drum loop. For the bass, I chose a fretless bass. The bass line is what makes the connection to Got to Give It Up. Now let's take a look into Ableton Live, where I arranged the blend. Ableton Live is another DAW or digital audio workstation. I chose Live this time around to get a different sound than I would get using Sonar. In the arrangement view, I've imported my clips I created in Reason. In addition, I have the Marvin Gaye and Robin Thicke records imported. One of the features that I like in Ableton is warping. Warping is similar to time stretching. In this project, I warped the Marvin Gaye song to make it the same tempo, and I also transposed the pitch down to match. I chopped a section from Got to Give It Up, looped it, and filtered it to take out the lower frequencies so they won't clash. I inserted an electric piano to play the chords that are in the original. Now here's where it gets fun. I wanted to create a little back and forth between Marvin and Robin, so I chopped some of the clips from both records. Here's the first section from Marvin. Once you get a feel for the interface in Ableton, it's a fun program to use. I like how easy it is to drag and drop effects. For this Marvin clip, I selected a reverb to give it a wider sound. For the clip of Robin, I used those effects and added a delay. I played the chord progression with the saxophone patch to give it another layer. The second back and forth is similar. I took the first clip from Marvin and then finished the measure with a little vocal run from Robin. And at the end of the track, I chopped a part of the ending from Got to Give It Up to play with my drums and faded it out. Thanks for watching Hip Hop Walkthroughs. To stream or download this track, check the description box for a link. Please subscribe to my channel and visit my blog to receive all updates from Sureshot Media.